Hare Krishna. Question: when everything is there in Srila Prabhupada's books, what is the need to read other books by other ISKCON devotees or by previous acharyas? Answer: there is a questionable causal connection between the two parts of this question, A and B. The Prabhupada himself said at times that everything is there in my books, but did he ever imply by that there is no need for us to read other books, especially either the previous acharya's books or the books that he wanted his disciples to read? Did he ever say that the Back to Godhead magazine which his disciples were writing, or that during his times Bhakti Swarupadamana wrote a book called The Science of Krishna Consciousness, The Scientific Basis of Krishna Consciousness, that these books were forbidden for his devotees, disciples to read? Prabhupada himself did not lead that point A means point B, that everything is in my books means that the preceding or succeeding books don't have to be read. In fact, to the contrary, Prabhupada appreciated the books that the devotees who wrote articles in BTG, and he appreciated those devotees who had literary inclinations and who wrote books, and especially when they wrote books which are properly according to Siddhanta. He was very pleased, and he personally displayed the books to his other disciples and to guests, and he appreciated those books. And as far as previous acharya's books are concerned, Prabhupada, for serious students, he definitely wanted the previous acharya's books to be read. So in the first canto, first chapter, first verse purport, Sir Prabhupada mentions that the serious students of the Bhagavatam should study the commentaries of the previous acharyas. And it's interesting that he doesn't even restrict himself to Gaudiya acharyas. He goes to other non-Gaudiya acharyas also who are in commentary in the Bhagavatam and mentions their names also. So it's not that A leads to B, that because everything is in Prabhupada's book, so therefore there's no need to read anything else. Now, so that's a wrong inference. Now going further, what does the statement everything is there in Prabhupada's books mean? It essentially means that Prabhupada's books contain all the instructions for us to go back to Godhead. But then Prabhupada also told us that a devotee is concerned more about serving Krishna than about going back to Godhead. So now, if for our service to Krishna, we need to know some specific subjects more, it's not wrong. So everything, it's no minimization of Srila Prabhupada's books to say that everything about every subject, or everything for that matter about Gaudiya Vaishnavism also, cannot be included in any one human being's books. Krishna is infinite, his glories are infinite, and even Antashesha, speaking for his thousand hoods for all time, since the time began, has not been able to exhaust Krishna's glory. So how can we say that everything is there in Prabhupada's books? If you are going to talk about everything in a literally everything sense, where everything means everything about Krishna's glories. No, it doesn't mean that. It means everything for us to go back to Godhead. But then, if some devotees want to study a particular book deeply, if somebody wants to study Bhagavad Gita deeply, and then there are Prabhupada's followers who have written books on the Gita, there are previous acharyas who have written books on the Gita, and studying that book can help us, and Prabhupada will be happy if we understand the Gita more deeply by studying previous acharyas' books also. And so with respect to Bhagavatam also. Or if somebody wants to do some specific kind of outreach, somebody wants to do scientific outreach, or somebody wants to do some outreach to academic audiences, those who study religion and Hinduism as a religious subject, then reading the specific books that devotees have written for that kind of audiences will be of enormous help. So we shouldn't think of this as a minimization of Prabhupada's books. Rather, we should see that Prabhupada has connected with a whole tradition that is ancient as well as current. We can't reduce the tradition to Srila Prabhupada alone. It's ancient means it goes back far, far, far for thousands, for hundreds and hundreds and thousands of years. And it is also current. So Prabhupada did not want ISKCON to be a personality cult. He wanted us to be a part of the Gaudiya tradition. And that means that we be acquainted with the larger tradition. Now, of course, those devotees who do not have the needs for preaching to any specific audience, they can read Prabhupada's books, and others should also read Prabhupada's books, of course. But if somebody doesn't want to read anything other than Prabhupada's books, that is wonderful. But if somebody says that nobody should read anything other than Prabhupada's books, that is not wonderful. That is an incorrect understanding of what the tradition stands for. And you also have to recognize that different devotees have different kinds of needs. Some devotees may be more intellectual, and they need more intellectual presentations of Krishna consciousness. So they will find within the tradition the elbow space, the room for dovetailing and utilizing their intellectual propensity. So therefore we need to recognize our own particular situation and find out how best we can be nourished in Krishna's service. And accordingly, we satisfy our intellectual needs. Never minimizing Prabhupada's books, but never minimizing the current and ancient tradition in the name of glorifying Prabhupada's books either also. A balanced attitude with a broad understanding that every devotee has to find out how one can be best nourished in Krishna's service and accordingly take nourishment. That is what we need to grow in our devotional service. So Prabhupada's books are like a vast ocean, and there are many, many jewels hidden in that ocean, and devotees can dive and extract the jewels from there. At the same time, if the ocean of Prabhupada's books is also Krishna's glories are not limited to that ocean alone. There are other oceans also in which Krishna's glories are there, and diving and drinking from that ocean, those oceans also for specific purposes, to either specific outreach purposes or specific individual needs, then that is perfectly okay, because we are connecting with the tradition, learning from the tradition, and living the tradition and expanding the tradition that Srila Prabhupada gave his life to expand. Thank you. Hare Krishna.